Welcome back to Treasure Hunting with Jeeves, guys, and today we're going to be counting down the top 10 best things we have ever found in abandoned storage units yet. So we've been doing this for about 3 months now, and we found all types of crazy, wild things. So I thought it'd be pretty fun to put together a quick little video and show you the 10 best things we have ever found to date. Make sure you leave the video a like, and without further ado, let's get into it. Number 10 on the list, first item. So this is not a single item, but this is a collection. In a very cheap unit in Maryland, we found not one, but an entire collection of shoes. I think total there were over 20 pairs, ranging from Tim's, Jordan's, foams, all kinds of very, very high-end shoes. If they were in great condition or like new condition, this easily would have been over $1,000 unit. But because these shoes weren't in the best of condition, the prices of them, of course, dropped a lot lower than it should have been. All in all, when all said and done, and we've sold just about all these shoes in this unit, I say we make an easy $300 to $500, a little more than that, maybe, depending on who we get them sold to. But overall, it was about a $40 unit, $400 or $500. A great start to the list. Number 9 on the list is something that we found very recently, and it is a single item. It was a Michael Kors watch. Unfortunately, this watch was not real gold. It was only stainless steel, but this watch, even in used condition, was selling for between $150 and in some places $200 in good working condition, which the watch we found was in. It has an absolutely beautiful face on the watch, and I was absolutely blown away when I found out how expensive this watch really was. Number 8 on the list was a very unexpected find. So we got a very cheap unit in an area in Maryland we had never been to before, and was going through it finding a lot of great clothes and dress clothes, but was definitely not expecting what we found in this little box. So in a box we picked up, we originally thought was going to be full of nothing but books, there ended up being not one, not two, not three, but four separate laptops all in one container. Unfortunately, none of the laptops were in great working condition, but they added up quick. A few of them were fairly new PCs with Windows 10 installed on them. A couple had Windows 7, and there was one very older one that was still running Windows XP. Even though none of them worked, we were able to sell them as a bundle for parts to someone locally for $200, which was absolutely insane. More than three times the cost of this unit, so I was definitely happy about that. Number 7, in the most expensive unit I have bought to date, there was an item that was labeled on the website as a computer monitor, but from looking at it, I did not think it was that, and when we got there to dig through this unit, I was exactly right. This was actually an Apple iMac laying in there in perfectly good working condition, just password locked. If we get this thing unlocked, it's easily a few hundred dollars made. Number 6, in the very same unit we found that Apple iMac in, there was also another item hiding on the opposite side on the unit. It was underneath the blanket and some other things. I do not think any of the other bidders noticed, but it was actually a 50-inch flat screen TV on a stand that was in absolutely flawless working condition. Now, a lot of TVs you pull out of storage units will end up not working or have flaws with them, but this one was in absolutely perfectly good working condition. There was not a single issue we could find out with it, and it was an easy sale within a couple days of bringing it home for over $200. Number 5 on the list was a 100% gamble unit. So we bought a unit in Washington, D.C. for $100 that we could see absolutely nothing in other than boxes and totes. Did not have high hopes for that, but that turned around really fast once we started going through the unit. Not only did we find an authentic Bell Staff leather jacket that we sold for $200 within the week of finding the unit, we also found a pair of these Isabel boots that were worth $400 brand new and were easily worth $200 sold. So on that $100 unit that we originally thought we were going to probably end up making little to no money on, we found very, very high-end clothes, $200 Bell Staff leather jacket, along with $400 plus, some places even higher than that, Isabel Marant, probably pronouncing that wrong, boots that were both sold. The jacket and the boots were both very easy sales, and that's not even taking into consideration all the other high-end clothes that were in this unit. So sometimes you just have to take the gamble. Number 4 on the list, in a very small unit that did not have much in it, that we picked up for about $40, we thought we came across a nice pair of sunglasses, but once we took a closer look at the case and the sunglass frames, we realized that we had found a pair of Gucci designer sunglasses.
Now I looked Gucci glasses up, saw them going for 100. I was hyped because that was more than twice what we paid for the unit. Looked up this particular one and these glasses were worth over $500. One of the most insane things we ever found. Number 3 on the list, in the very first storage unit that we have ever bought, we paid $180 for a 5x10 unit that we had no idea what was in. And to be honest with you, I only bid the guy up because I wanted to do this and record a video for the very first time. We did not have high hopes of making money. However, after going through every last thing in the unit and getting to the very end, the last 6 boxes in the storage unit were completely loaded with vinyl records. All in the cases, not in the greatest of condition, but every single record we found just about was in its original sleeve. Going all the way back to the 70s, I mean, very well-known artists were in there. Now, I didn't think much of it because I wasn't very sure on how nice records were or how much they were worth, but after talking to a few people, we were able to get $120 from a record store, $150 from another buyer for some records, and then an additional $120 from somebody else. So nearly $400 on these records. The unit only cost $180, and that was within 3 days of picking this unit up. I had no idea how easy records were to sell, and it absolutely blew my mind to make that much money. And since this unit, I was absolutely hooked on buying and reselling stuff at storage auctions. Number 2 on this list. So in a cheap $30 unit that we picked up in Maryland that we thought was going to be nothing but clothes, which ended up being partially true, this unit ended up absolutely blowing my mind. So far, this is the most viewed video we have on our entire channel with nearly 800,000 views, and is pretty much responsible for the insane growth we've experienced over the last month. We found a unit that most definitely belonged to a drug dealer. We found a lot of paraphernalia, weed remnants, baggies for packaging weed, baggies for packaging pills, scales, all types of things that pointed to the fact that he was a drug dealer. But in the different things, we found so many pairs of high-end shoes, Foamposites, Tims, Nikes, LeBrons, I mean, all types of great shoes. And the reason this one was so higher ranked than the other shoe lot, even though that one had more, is these shoes were all in basically brand new condition. After maybe 5 minutes of cleaning each shoe per pair, these shoes looked absolutely flawless. And to this day, we've sold just about every single pair of shoes that we had in this unit. And that's not even talking about the clothes. We also found a expensive coat, multiple expensive coats, one that I still wear to this day, I think, came out of this unit. But the shoes and the clothes that we found in this unit, it was a $30 storage unit, has netted us already over $500 or $600. I don't remember the exact number, but when it's all said and done and we sold the last few things, I guarantee we're right at $1,000, if not over $1,000 on a $30 storage unit. The ones that nobody ever wants to buy, the ones that look little, the ones that look like they're only clothes, those are the ones we like to go for. They're easy to move and they're always great money, and it's easy to look stuff up, easy to price. But when it's all said and done, it will definitely be around $1,000 cash on a $30 storage unit, which is just ridiculous. Number 1 on our list so far came out of a unit that we picked up in Washington, D.C., our second storage unit ever, and probably one of the reasons I'm so ridiculously addicted to this. So we bought a unit in D.C., going through a bunch of envelopes and bags, and one of the envelopes had cash. After counting up all the foreign money, we were about $80 cash, U.S. cash, after trading that in. But then there was a stash of U.S. money, old bills that ended up being over $500. There ended up being over $30 in twos and an additional $50 to $60 in ones. When all was said and done in this unit, we ended up with over $750 U.S. cash currency on, I think it was a $70 to $90 unit, I don't remember exactly. But over $750 in cash. Cash is king in this business. This blew my mind. I still freak out and tell people this story all the time to this day. Cash is just something you don't find very often in storage units, considering most people lose them because they can't pay their bills. It doesn't really make sense. So whatever happened to this guy, something had to happen to him to where he was not able to get back in this, whether he passed away, whether he was deported, arrested, we don't know, because we found a lot of foreign money in here, so we don't know the story behind it. All we know is that this was the greatest thing we ever found in this storage unit to date, and it was an absolutely mind-blowing experience that I will probably tell people about until I can barely walk anymore.
Hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, let me know about it in the comments. What was your favorite thing that we found in these abandoned storage units so far, and what video was the one that actually got you here? I know a lot of people showed up with that drug dealer unit. Let me know what video got you here if you've just been an OG fan that's been here for over a year. Let me know all that in the comments down below. This is the craziest things that we have found so far in just 3 months of doing this. I can't wait to see what this list looks like in another 3 months or a year from now. I can only imagine how insane the things are we're going to continue to find in these units. But that is going to be it, guys. So thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy it, make sure you leave it a big fat thumbs up. And if you're not already, hit that subscribe button for awesome treasure hunting videos every single day of the week. Storage units, dumpster diving, thrift stores, yard sales, flea markets, anything like that. We're always on the hunt for treasures. And if you want to follow us on our social media links, they'll be on screen. Just click the links down in the description below. Make sure you follow us on whatever you have. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, peace out.